If you want respect, you gotta earn it. You damn right.
Mic check. 1-2-1-2. Back to it. Here to do it. It's hard to earn. Your boy Tours of the building.
B. Bonesu Thompson. You already know what it is, man. Hard to earn is back in the building.
Big facts. Thanks, y'all, for tapping in with us. Another great conversation we got lined up. You know, we like to do the classic albums, and we like to pull up some of these new projects.
Got to, man.
As well, man. Today, this episode is 2 Chainz' Dope Don't Sell Itself.
It doesn't.
Does it not, though?
It does not.
I thought that when I first heard that title, I thought it was the contradiction of it. I thought dope does sell itself. It's already dope. It's like you don't got to promote it.
No, that's not true. You know how many dope ass MCs do we know that didn't really get the love they were supposed to get?
They didn't sell themselves.
They didn't sell it because they don't sell it.
Got it. Dope doesn't. 2 Chainz, 6th solo album, 7th in total.
Yeah.
B, what's your take on 2 Chainz?
2 Chainz is interesting, man, because it's like he's definitely, he falls into like that quintessential Southern rapper artist, trap rapper. But he also is barred up at times.
At times,
right? And I think that's kind of what my issue is with 2 Chainz sometimes, because like he gets lazy. You know what I'm saying? Like he has, like he could play around with the lingo, and I wish a nigga would like a kitchen cabinet. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like
you love representing you know that bar, bro.
It's hilarious. It's terribly good. That's why. It's a terribly good line. He can go bar for bar with any of the top dudes when he wants to. You know what I'm saying? He just doesn't always do it. And I think like that lack of consistent top tier lyricism, when he, I know he's capable of it, is a little bit annoying at times. You know?
I think that's us as fans, as you know
for
what I'm
sure,
saying?
For sure.
For lack of a better term, purists, right? We love this shit. But you look at, you know, you call it like the Cam'ron effect, right? When Cam'ron was rapping his best raps,
great example.
He was not the most successful rapper.
No.
As he started to pull back on the lyricism, he became more and more, you know what I'm saying? Became more and more palatable and definitely way more, monetarily at least, successful in what you want to do. And ultimately, part of the game and part of the goal is to get to the bag.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So I think 2 Chainz understands that. He understands that. He don't gotta go so hard. He don't gotta go barred up. When he wants to, I think he can show flashes. But for the most part, he does what's easy, what comes natural, what's easy to him. And you know, like I said, we on album number 7.
I think the only space for him to like, the only way for him to go to that next level is to stay consistently lyrically.
Precisely.
To actually try. I'm not saying he could. I'm just saying, but like to try to make the J. Cole's and the Kendrick's his peers.
Right.
From the South.
Right.
Like,
right.
But Tip used to balance that perfectly.
Right. Right. I feel that. And that brings us right to where we at, right? The new album, Dope Don't Sell Itself, because what I've been waiting for from 2 Chainz for a couple of albums now is that moment.
Right.
Is that I made a bunch of money. I'm an entrepreneur. Right. You know I know how to make hit records. I got a ton of plaques. I got a ton of accolades. Now I just really want to focus in on this rapping shit and show y'all, for whomever is a doubter, a non-believer, that I can do this. You know what I'm saying? Because you said we've seen him rap with some of the best of them, some of the people that we consider to be top tier MCs, and he's held his own. So like, why not really just tap
he's
in and give
the,
us that?
He's rap with the best.
Give us that on the album.
Yeah.
I didn't get that this album.
I didn't get. Yeah, I mean, we got glimpses line wise, but like, there's maybe like maybe 2 whole verses that I was really rocking with. Like
big
maybe
facts.
2. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
It's some lines here, but like, and you know what I'll give him credit for? I think, you know, the production, again, big part of your music. The production holds up well for the most part. And he used a lot of new producers. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? To give them a shot. But the funny thing is, sometimes like the production from the newer cats actually is better than 2 Chainz' lyrical performance. Let's get into it, man.
Let's set it right off. Bet It Back.
Yeah.
First joint on the album after the, you know, intro or whatever. You know, it's a good high energy record. You know what I mean? I think it was a good, like, energetic way to start the project. I think Steve Francis got an unnecessary stray.
Ooh, unnecessary though? It was accurate.
It's accurate. It's unnecessary because why?
Yeah, why?
Like, why when you bring that man up for?
That man's from Maryland.
Nobody asked me, no problems. You know what I mean? He didn't show up at the NBA 75 looking for a jacket.
Yo.
He just doing his thing.
What, he wasn't whispering in Magic Johnson's ear?
Yeah, nah. He wasn't feeling on Mary J. Blige.
Well, unfortunately.
Like some legends were. So let me see. What's the bar? Off the rap game, I bought 3 mansions. You niggas ain't aging well. You like Steve Francis. Yeah. Like a janitor, I got keys dancing. Last plaque I got, I had to freelance it. I don't necessarily understand that part.
Freelance it. I think he was, I assumed he was talking about like he got the plaque because he did a feature.
Yeah,
remember he was leading the game in features for a minute.
Okay, that's what I got from it.
That's what I
saw. But yeah, overall it's a cool joint. You know, like I said, high energy joint. 2 Chainz is doing what he does. Nothing really stellar lyrically on it, but very much 2 Chainz for the 2 Chainz fans. Exactly. I think is what you expect.
Quality energy. It's a good warm up. It gets us right into the record.
No doubt. I work hard to get where I'm at. Look at where I'm at. I like that ball because that's real life shit.
Word up.
You know what I'm saying? What'd you give it?
8.
Gave it an 8.
Solid 8.
I gave it an 8, and ooh, then I went back.
You went 7.5.
I gave it 7.5.
Because?
Because there's some other 8s on the album that I didn't think it was as good as.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. But this, for me, and I mean, spoiler alert, this album is not rated high. It's not highly rated. It's not highly rated for me at all. Which, and I'm a Chainz fan. Like I'm a fan of Chainz music.
We know.
I think he says witty shit. I know he can go.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Like I'll argue anybody down. He can go.
Yeah, for sure. He's rhymed with the best and done his thing. Like
and he's super successful. He's a cool dude. Good dude. Super, you know what I'm saying? Been around him.
Great personality. Yeah.
Hung out with him at the studio. Interviewed him.
Yeah.
I hung out with him in strip club. We've been in each other's presence numerous times. So I like Chainz, but I keep waiting for the best for you.
Exactly.
That's why you want more. And I keep waiting for that project.
I feel that Rick Ross verses, man, like really kind of showed exactly like why, you know what I'm saying? What I feel like he's missing. Like
you really saw the difference. Yeah, for
like,
sure.
Like y'all are supposed to be peers. Right. Like Rick Ross, y'all are supposed to be peers, and like there was a gap there, man. And it's not like you didn't have records.
Right.
It was like those records don't move the way some of his album records move. Like, why is that?
You think about it, right? And that was almost like the start of the, it's not always about the hit record.
No.
It's about the feel of the record. It's about the impact. It's about what the record does. Like, I don't remember exactly what records were played, but 2 Chainz got records that are bigger than Santorini, Greece.
Absolutely.
Santorini, Greece is something special, though.
Rick Ross, while again, Rick Ross isn't like top 3 lyrically, he still always delivers.
For sure.
You know what I'm saying? He's never lazy.
He puts a lot more emphasis on making good music.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying?
Exactly.
He puts a lot more emphasis on making, he respects the music, so he makes good music.
Exactly.
So we're going to get into the next joint, Pop Music, featuring Moneybagg Yo and Beat King. It's one of the singles off the project.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not a fan.
Not a fan.
Not a fan.
It's not my mix, but I mean, I think it does what it's supposed to do.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, I think, actually, we were talking about Titty lyrically, but like, he paints a picture. You know what I'm saying? You can see homegirl, you know, she got her ass done. She's outside. Her friend is her champion. She's her hype woman. You know what I'm saying? Like, you can see them taking pictures. She dancing. He painted a very good picture.
For sure.
He could have mailed it in and just talked about the usual shit, which he does often on this joint. But like, with this one, I actually appreciated it. Like, you know, it's a hit single. It's a club record, but also like he paints us that setting. You know what I'm saying? Very well. You know what I mean? And I appreciate that lyrically.
Yeah, he can do that. I think he can do that with ease. I think he does that without trying. Like to be able to stay on topic and paint the picture and all that. But I feel like because he can do that with ease, I don't give the credit for it. You know what I'm saying?
It's like
when I listen to the Continents record, and again, I know where records to aim for. It was one of the most added records. Like, it did what it needed to do, right? It's what you got to do. It's the music and it's the business. But I just want more. I want more. And I almost feel like this record is a step back. I almost feel like he regressed a little bit.
Really?
Yeah, because it's just a lot more the same, but not done as well as he's done in the past.
Yeah, I just thought it was what it was.
It is what it is.
Real.
But
again, it's not my type of record, but for those who like, I mean, I think it has elements.
Like,
that it's
not as
to
good as Birthday Song.
Of course not, right? It's not as good.
But it's really the same record.
Right.
It's the same attempt. It's the same type of record, but it's not as good.
Which is why I gave it an 8.
Oh, okay.
And I would have gave Birthday, you know, like a 9.
Right. You know what I'm saying? Well, I gave it a 7.
Give it a 7.
Yeah. Okay, beats, the bars, not very special for me.
Moneybagg Yo is going to do what he does,
which is
rhyme off beat. I mean, you know what I'm saying? Now you're gonna give me that real, give me that street talk, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, he said, you know,
it's also a weird combination. I guess the Beat King aspect of it.
I mean, it makes. I mean, he made sense on this record. It's just, here's what it is. You're gonna get with, if you're a fan of you know, of that type of shit. Again, it's hard for me to love MCs who occasionally rhyme off beat. That's just my thing. So I mean, like, no shade at all. I mean, that's just, but that's accepted
right,
nowadays.
Right, for sure.
We talk about Kodak Black. Like, I fuck with certain Kodak Black songs, but he does that consistently.
Kodak got a lot of good records.
He does, but he
let
also
let me not say a lot because the internet they'll staple me to a lot. He got joints though.
Yo, I love the No Flocking record. I have friends who
No Flocking is excellent.
But he's also offbeat on that shit a lot.
Yeah, man. You know, wasn't a special joint to me, man.
Moving along.
Kingpin Ghostwriter.
Kingpin Ghostwriter. That's a heavy title, man.
I was going to say, when I saw the title, I was like, wow, you can go a few different places with that. I like the title. I want to see where he takes it. And I wasn't disappointed. It wasn't what I thought it could be.
I like this track, though.
I like the track.
Buddha Blues?
Yeah. I like the track.
Yeah.
Even the title, like, is a double entendre, right?
Right, yep.
Kingpin,
yep.
Ghostwriter.
Yep.
Or a kingpin could be my ghostwriter, because right. The shit I talk about, right?
Kingpin,
with the pen shit. So yeah, I like that. And then, you know, we spoke about this on numerous occasions, but Lil Baby is my favorite rapper of the new generation of rappers.
That boy raps.
Bigger than the rapping shit, he finds these really, really intricate pockets, and he nails them shits.
I'm like,
how you find that little part between the snare and the kick to go in on and really drill at?
I'd be fascinated at his delivery. Like, I'm like, yo, he could also remove like a word or two from every bar. Like, he gets every single word.
But with clarity. Yeah. Like, shout out to Lil Baby.
Raps, man. And again, He got chains on his record.
Sure. Easy.
He got chains on his record. I'm like, you can't get on with, you can't have a guest, you can't have the guy, right, the new guy,
right,
on your record and, as a veteran, and get your ass beat.
Yeah. Like, because you know he's going to show up.
That's why you got him on the record.
You know he's going to show up. Like, that's what he does. He's done it time and time again. He shows up on his records, on features. So you know that you got to bring your hard hat and your lunch pail to the studio that day and really get to work.
Teflon vest, man.
Yeah. Shout out to Lil Baby. When it come to trapping, I'm like 2-3. That was a 2 Chainz bar. Mm-hmm. You know. Again, it's a lot of more the same. You know, it's no new ground covered. What else? Water on the neck, it ain't tap. You know, like, I thought those lines were cute.
Yeah.
But overall, you know, not a lot of new ground covered. But when Lil Baby comes in is where the record gets exciting.
Yeah.
For me. You know what I mean?
Absolutely. I mean,
the beat is dope.
I mean, like, you know, the hook is cool. Yeah. The beat is tough. I mean, it's interesting because there's really not a lot I don't like about this record. Is like the weak point happens to be 2 Chainz.
Just so happens.
Author.
What'd you give it?
8.5.
8.5. Okay. Yeah. I gave it an 8.
Solid.
Yeah. Probably joint.
More like an 8. Yeah.
Solid joint. Next joint featuring Roddy Ricch.
Ooh,
outstanding.
I'm very interested in hearing what you think about this record.
Well, set it off, B.
Hit-Boy produced it.
Oh, is that a Hit-Boy joint?
Hit-Boy, it's a Hit-Boy record, yeah. Hit-Boy produced it. heavy trap keys, you know, got that gospel bass. I'm a big fan of Roddy Ricch, man.
What about the producer?
Huh? Am I a big fan of Hit-Boy? I appreciate him. He's good.
All right.
He's a good producer.
Nah, I think so.
He's a good producer.
I think previous episodes may...
What?
Oh. They challenged what I mean, you I mean, just said
I
here.
I mean, we can talk about King's Disease 2 all day.
No, we're not.
Do that.
No, we can't. No, actually, we can't.
I want to focus. I actually like this beat. You know what I'm saying?
Say what you were saying,
I actually
bro.
Like this beat. I'm trying to. I actually like this beat. I like this beat. I really like Roddy Ricch. Big fan of Roddy Ricch. He's just really talented with melodies. I feel like this record could have been really boring. You know what I'm saying? It could have been nothing. And like, he just came in and just gave it
some energy.
He's like, he has a certain, it's not even that he's good with melody. He finds like a melody that only he could make. He just makes it special.
Yeah.
And I feel like the record actually could have been bigger if 2 Chainz would have actually showed up. And again, you can't have a Hit-Boy beat, get Roddy Ricch on your hook, and then
it got underwhelming. Like, he was the underwhelming part of it. And again, like, it pains me to say it because I don't want to feel like I'm shitting on Chainz, but he just, I don't know if he's gotten to that point where he's not as excited about making music or
Distracted? Who knows?
Distracted. Yeah, you know, he got like, we know he got tons of shit going on, things going on. But when you get to that point, I think it's good to step away and come back with that new energy.
Fresh, yeah.
Come back reinvigorated, come back re-excited and shit. You know what I'm saying? Because it's not necessarily that you have something to prove, but you want to have something to prove to yourself that 7 albums in, 8 albums in, 9 albums in, you still deliver.
Right.
And I think there's also, I know, the competitiveness of 2 Chainz, when they do that next Kylie Grove album and he's rapping with Wayne, he's not going to be taking bars off.
Better not.
You absolutely better not. Get your ass whooped. Like you, like your mother caught you cursing in school. You know what I mean? You're going to get your ass bust if you do that with Wayne. So I think that it's about making sure you play not to the level of your competition, but you play to your level, your skill set every trip.
It's played to the level of your potential.
Yeah,
man.
Yeah. And I just don't feel like he did that on the joint. But it's a solid joint. Yeah. You know, like we said.
I thought it could have been a special joint.
It could have been a way better record.
But it's not. I gave it an 8.
I gave it 7.5. Cool. Yeah.
Oof, cream.
Pretty critical.
You critiquing like me today. I like this.
I'm not welcome at Escobar, whatever other establishments he owns.
Bro,
Neighbors Know My Name. Feel like I've heard that title somewhere before.
Mr. Tremaine.
Yo, incredible record, yo. Trey Songz, Neighbors Know My Name.
Fire record.
Incredible record.
That album is actually tough, but yeah.
Oh, yeah, Reddy's a crazy album. Yeah, so, you know, obviously Neighbors Know My Name. I assume that he's going to follow suit of the record that we've already heard with the same title. It's a few places you could go with it, but, you know, I figured 2 Chainz fashion, he'll probably stick to the script.
Keep it safe.
Yeah, keep it safe.
About then, the Laffy Taffy sample.
Then we hear the D for L Laffy Taffy sample.
Yeah.
So, I don't have a love-hate relationship with Laffy Taffy, but Laffy Taffy is like the punchline of snap rap in that era, in that sound.
Absolutely.
It's the go-to, right? It was a big record, successful for D4L.
Huge.
You know, shout out to all of them. But it's like a joke almost.
Right.
So to use that, to flip that, I thought was adventurous. And if you're going to do it, can you do it right? Can you make it work?
I think, I mean,
did they make it work?
He's doing the rehash, right? Because the kids who are going to flock to that record today weren't really around or outside when D4L was popping. So it's like, oh, this sounds familiar, but it sounds, we can't really place it. So it's a 2 Chainz record.
Can't quite put my finger on it.
It's catchy. So it's like, you know, they're going to gravitate to it. Yeah, I don't really have a ton to say about this record, man.
Rest in peace to Shorty Low.
It's a short record. It's on the nose. He doesn't really give us anything really extra. We get it. This textual prowess, like, you know, he's laying it down. Cool. He's not even doing it. And this is why I'm saying, like, people always want to give my guy Pusha Static for, like, always talking about coke. But I'm like,
here we go.
Again, if you could talk about the same topic in a very creative way over and over again, that shows skill.
I can't wait till this Pusha album show up.
Me too.
I know you can. I know. Yeah, I feel you on that though. He had a couple lines, at least on this one, that were amusing to me.
Like,
you know what I'm saying? Like I laughed at it and I went back to she called me daddy, she don't even call it daddy. You know what I'm saying? Like, funny. What else? Look at this guy.
It's toxic.
Maybach so big it came with the office and the secretary. You know, visual shit, right?
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah, you've been in the back, you know, yeah, shit like that. Yeah. I leave the door unlocked just in case a best friend walk in.
I like that.
I like that. Yeah, I bet you do.
I like that.
you know what I mean?
You never know.
If she walk in, it's all voluntary.
A good night could turn
to a great night.
Yeah.
Easily.
Yeah, absolutely.
Not that I would know anything about that.
Nah, not me. I keep the doors locked, man.
Yeah, I know. We don't.
Privacy.
So,
very private person.
Where did you land on this record?
7.5.
I landed on 7.5 as well. 7.5 as well. $1 million worth of game. I feel like I've heard that.
Damn.
Phrase title somewhere before. Have you heard that somewhere before?
A few places. A
couple places.
Yeah, a few places.
Yeah, man. This was another single off the project. Features 42 Doug,
mm-hmm,
out of Detroit. You got any feelings on 42 Doug?
Not really.
You familiar with any of the music?
Yeah. It's not for me.
Definitely not.
Not for me. I get the appeal, you know. Is it these new artists, a lot of them, like, I actually like a lot of them outside of the music. Like, I fuck with their grind, I fuck with their story. You know, like, they're not speaking to me.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? They're 20 years younger,
right,
completely different life. Even the street game is different, you know, for the 20-year-old now. You know what I'm saying? That it was when I was a kid. So, but I understand why Chainz wanted to have, you know, have him on his record. But it's just, musically, it's just not fire.
He reached for, like, that generation. I think that was intentional. Because if you look at all of the features, right, it's pretty much all the new kids. Yeah. You know, or that next crop of artists. You know, 42 Doug is somebody that a lot of people are saying is going to be one of the next ones. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, like
The beat was hard, though. I mean, the beat's a little tough.
I actually got the beat was annoying.
Really?
Yeah, I was annoyed by the beat. Let's get into it. Like, let's play that $1 million worth of game.
Annoying.
42 Doug was going in, though. For what he does, I felt like he was... I felt like he delivered. But the bottom is crazy. It's a trunk rattling joint. And I think Chainz actually spoke to wanting to make that, you know what I'm saying? Like, wanting that to be the sound and wanting that to be the theme for the joint. But not one of my favorite joints. It's not for me. And again, man, a Chainz fan, I just keep it... I keep wanting and anticipating the album that I know he can make. $1 million worth of game, I gave it 7.
Same.
Okay, word up. Free BG.
Free BG.
Shout out to them hot boys. Shout out to all my peoples in that NOLA.
I miss BG's. Hot boy had some shit.
So which album was it for you? Was it Chopper City or was it Chopper City in the Ghetto?
It was the Koch record?
The Koch record was fire.
That's my shit.
The Koch record was fire.
That's my shit.
I was actually making a joke because he made an album called Chopper City and then he made an album called Chopper City in the Ghetto. No, not two. He just added extra words. Like, what is... Are these the same? Is this a deluxe? I thought he was doing a deluxe before the deluxe. Chopper City in the Ghetto.
Oh, man.
But yeah, the Koch album, like when he moved away from
BG,
the Hot Boys and Cash Money. Yeah, BG was on some shit.
BG got away from that Cash Money shit. Boy, that boy raps.
Juvenile has some shit too, post-Cash Money.
Absolutely.
Some of his best... Haas is my favorite record. But some of his best, like, absolute best records came after that moment.
He had another hit too.
Slow Motion. Rest in peace, Soldier Slim. Slow Motion might be... Nah, it's not his biggest record, but it's big.
No, Back That Ass Up.
Yeah, Back That Ass Up is his biggest record.
Is that his record, though?
It's all their records, but it's on his album. I was gonna say it's on his album, so you got the pub, but it went to Baby. It's Baby's biggest album.
Oh man.
Free BG.
Acting like I killed a baby.
Told to me, B.
I mean, he's rapping on this. He actually rapping on this. I appreciated it, man. Clever lines. He's bring that 2 Chainz wit, man. Like, you know, the concept. Number one, he's giving a shout out to an underground legend.
For sure.
Right? Incarcerated, you know what I'm saying? That boy was a wild boy, too. You've been around BG?
No.
Oh, wait.
Thank goodness.
That's a wild boy. My brother knows this story, but I sat next to that dude one time in the whip. This dude spent literally 5 whole minutes looking for his lighter and dropped his pistol twice while looking for that shit, bro. But kept the conversation going, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, as if he never dropped a pistol the first time. I'm like, yo, what is... I'm like, you out here dirty.
Yeah, I was in
Nolan. Huh?
Yeah, I was in Nolan.
It was in Atlanta, actually.
Oh, okay.
It was Atlanta, actually. I think this is when Tip signed him.
Okay. You know them boys came straight out the street, though.
The Mud.
Yeah, like, they got, for real.
Mud.
Yeah.
Like those...
Chopper City in the Ghetto.
Bruh, their projects are different from Cypress, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
New York. Like, it's different, man. But yeah, I fuck with BG heavy. Like, my brother was a big BG fan, and, like, you know, I started to appreciate his music more. My brother started getting down with him, too. Because I was always the dude, I was like, yo, why isn't the little kid from Cash Money rapping more? Like, he's nice. Wayne. Yeah, I was like, yo, this dude, he wasn't really saying shit, but, like, yo, his delivery is crazy. He moves like a star.
I'm about to say, he was always a star.
He
always stole the
show. And then he started rapping. And I was like, whoa, okay.
Right.
I wasn't tripping. Like, this dude, anyway. Yeah. But BG had bars. BG had records.
Hot Boys collective
stupid.
Solid.
Yeah. I mean, Boys, bling, forget.
Yeah, Hot Boys as a collective, they all, you know, the best parts of all of them came out in those records.
Yeah.
I got almost opposite feelings on this record.
Really? You don't like this record at all?
It's lazy as fuck to me.
Lazy as fuck? I disagree.
Hot Boys, Free BG. Like, that's so cliche almost.
Not even cliche. Nobody's doing it though. It's a homage.
It is, but it's done really lazily.
It's just it's a slow bop, but it's on purpose. He actually shows more thought on this than we have at all the last 3 records we talked about.
Well, because there's somewhat of a concept there, but I still feel like it's lazy.
I just think it's a stanza, man. Like, it's just a pocket that he's in. I don't. Okay, that's.
Yeah, it just gets repetitive.
It doesn't do anything for you. I mean, yeah, it's a repetitive theme. Yeah, that's what it is. It's a theme, man.
Yeah, man.
Definitely he's not like.
The beat is cool. But I just feel like he didn't really.
I thought the beat was tough, man.
Yeah. I gave it a 7.5.
Oof. I gave it an 8.5.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, you fuck with it?
Yeah.
You want to get into it? You want to play it? Let's play it.
Let's play it. Let's play it.
The bounce is there. The bop is there. But because he took so much off on the bars, the PPP, like, come on, bro. You better than that, bro.
I like that. But P's with PPP. I like that. I like it. It's, again, it's super simple. You know what? I like, they're going to love that shit in Memphis, man.
Nah, they're going to fuck with it.
They're going to love that shit in Memphis.
But the bar is so low that that can't be my barometer.
Because of Memphis?
Just because in general, the standard is set so low that just because they gonna love it doesn't mean that it's good. Because they take anything. All right, let's turn the volume up a little bit, man. Let's turn the energy up
10 bracelets?
A little bit. Yeah, let me sit up straight in my chair. Let me get my posture correct.
10 bracelets?
10 bracelets featuring YoungBoy.
It's a lot of bracelets, man.
10, I mean, pause. 2 Chainz is long, right? He's got long arms. He's tall. 10 break, 5 on each wrist?
I'm not mad. Whatever.
How do you want to give it up? Get it how you live.
Yeah, whatever. You can Mr. T it.
I got one watch. I'm good.
I see it. Nice watch.
I got one watch. He wears 2 Chainz. I see what you did there. I'm going to leave it alone. He wears 2 Chainz. Why not 10 braces? One of my favorite joints on the project. Really like the beat.
Yeah.
You know, the chorus is dope. I said it's not innovative, but it's the best we've heard so far.
It's like Buddha's actually providing like the best production on this album,
man.
This is my favorite beat.
Or one of my favorite beats, and it's overall one of my favorite joints.
Catchy hook.
Yeah.
All of that, right?
Yeah, yeah. It's like what I say about the chorus. It's not innovative, but it's the best we heard. Like, it's catchy.
Yeah.
It does what it needs to do. When I first heard the sample as it was coming in, it instantly made me raise an eyebrow and pay more attention.
Right, right.
And it didn't let me down. And that's really what I've been waiting for. Right. Like, just don't let me down, bro. Like, live up to what we know, what I know you can do and what I believe you can do.
Right, right. What do you think about YoungBoy Neva's performance?
I thought YoungBoy did all right on this record.
Did his thing,
yeah,
man.
Yeah, yeah.
He did his thing.
So my son, you know, my son is 14, right? So he's definitely into that. So he talk about Sincerely Control all the time. That's the latest YoungBoy album.
Okay.
Talk about how crazy it is, how he's one of the best of the new guys or whatever, whatever.
Really?
And so when I heard this, I was like, oh, maybe I need to listen.
Nah, he's saying some. He's saying,
maybe I need to listen more.
Because again, it's still some street shit, but like what he's saying, this is what you love about it, right? It's like, yo, you always talking about guns, blah, blah, blah. But it's like, you could talk about street shit, you could talk about coke, but you can talk about it in a creative way. This dude's like giving us, like, he's telling us about his personal stuff.
Yeah.
You know, homeboys at turn. Him looking out for him, he's bringing his ego in it, being prideful, family issues. And I'm like, yeah,
I'm
bro,
with it.
Peel those layers back. Yeah. You could talk about where you from, but give us a little more, go a little deeper. You know what I'm saying? Sure. Give us something that we haven't heard before.
Yeah, yeah. Did YoungBoy steal the show?
No. Didn't steal the show because actually Chainz came through on this one.
Chainz is rapping on
it.
I'll say that he surprised me only because I don't listen to so much of his music.
Right.
I didn't have any preconceived notion going in, but I definitely like what I heard.
Same.
And it's shit like that makes me go back and listen to other music from you, because now I know, oh, there's capability there.
Yeah.
Let me see what other joints you got. And there's tons of records we play on my radio show that I never listen to. But you know what I'm saying?
Rock the pills.
Now that I'll go back and check it out. What did you what'd you get this joint?
8.5.
8.5. I gave it an 8.
Okay.
Because I'm mad critical.
Being stingy today. I like Stingy Torre.
I'm mad critical.
I like the Pyrex is Jewish.
Today.
I like Stingy.
You know you can't say that no more.
What?
Can't say that, yo.
Can't say Jewish?
Nah.
You cannot say Jewish.
Nah,
what do you say?
Well, in that term, they find it derogatory.
In that term? It's not even a real thing. How can Pyrex can't be Jewish?
When you say Jewish and stingy or anything about them being cheap or not, you know what I'm saying? Like,
well, I didn't say stingy. It's like
it was coming off the stingy.
It's conservative. Conservative.
Frugal?
Pyrex is conservative.
All right. Fuck around. That'd be a Pusha song.
It's a Pusha line. Pyrex is Jewish.
I said song.
Oh, God damn it.
Lost Kings. Content.
Whoa.
I like when we get to content. Whoa. It only took us 20 records to get here.
Sheesh, man. Thank God it wasn't 20. But Strong song, man. One of the strongest on the album.
For sure, for sure.
You know, powerful hook.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? You got Dirk on there. Brings. I mean, everybody does their thing. Everybody sure. does their job.
Totally
well,
agree. Totally know, agree. Sleepy Rose, though. Sleepy Rose did the thing. Yeah. Sleepy. I'm not, and I'm 10,000% unfamiliar with Sleepy Rose.
Some, well, yeah, same. I was like, okay, what the, what the? I like, I get Chains. I start with Chains, right?
Mm-hmm.
He paints that picture. He gives us... He telling us about his family members.
Yeah, he telling us about homies that we don't, you know.
We didn't know
popular
about.
Popular people and people we don't know.
Lost loved ones. He's talking about giving us, you know, staying by the airport and hearing the sirens and the right. planes over there, giving us right. that visual.
Yeah, imagery.
Imagery, man. We want that, man. For it's sure. like, this is what I love from Titty. Like, you can still give us that.
That's what you love from Titties?
Yo, I said Titty. Just one. Just one. No. It's a boob. One boob.
One
boob.
Just one solid Titty.
One boob. That's all we need. One boob.
Just one area.
Nobody jumps from breast to breast. Like, you got that one.
Shit, I'm nobody then, nigga, because I jumps.
See, this is why my man on this. You see the Similac kids?
I'm a Similac child.
You see the Similac kids?
Oh, dude. Man, you guys crazy.
Bad.
Yeah, nah, but you know, like, it's like my DNA, despise a coward, shit like that.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like, I like shit like that. You already touched on yeah. some of the other lines and just the imagery of it all, man. Solid,
I was on a trampoline. I was on a triple beam. Like, I was working a triple beam. Like,
come on. Look at this juxtaposition,
I
right?
Love
what
it.
We doing?
I've been outside. You know what I'm saying? Like, I talk that shit. I like it. Just do it in a creative way, man.
Yeah.
You're not saying nothing new, but it's in a creative way, man.
I have in capital said more. I want more. This is what I want. I want more of this.
Yeah.
The point is, when you get to a certain point in your career and you make X amount of bread and you have X amount of hits, you can be a lot more free with your music, right?
Absolutely.
Go in, like, 444, right? We talk about Hov. Hov thing, hey, there's no single on there. You know what I'm saying? There's some records that were pulled from the album, Liberated, and they made video.
Yeah.
But it's not, yo, we need a radio record. We need a record that's going to, yo, I'm just going to give you these records.
Yeah.
I'm just going to give you these records. And if some hit, it hit. But that's not the intent. And I feel like 2 Chainz gave us a lot of records, attempts at radio, attempts at this. When you get, I feel like, this is just me. I'm speaking for myself. It's me, P, speaking for myself. I feel like 2 Chainz is accomplished enough that he could just give us the dope. You know what I mean? Give us the dope that don't sell itself. Because this record...
I feel like this was the album he was supposed to do that on. This was supposed to be the street brilliance.
But it's what I've been waiting for. It's not consistent.
It's
just flashes. It's flashes like we've gotten his whole career.
And the times where he could have been special, he doesn't come through. Like, that's the biggest
crime. Right. Yeah.
It's not like he had potential. You got Hit Boy. You pay for Hit Boy beat. You pay for a Dirk feature, right? You pay for all of this stuff. You pay for Roddy Ricch a hook.
You work at Def Jam Finance Department?
Maximize it. Or swapped it out, whatever it was.
Whatever it was.
I don't care if it was 80 conversations to make that happen. You invested some kind of energy into it.
For sure.
Capitalize on that shit.
For sure.
Be your best.
It's flashes. Ten bracelets is a flash of greatness.
Yeah.
This joint is a flash of greatness.
Chainz, yeah.
Lost Chainz.
And again, back, you know, again, Sleep. I don't know who this kid Sleepy is, but like, I love
it. I'm paying attention.
I'm on it.
Yeah,
he got my ears perked. I'm on it.
And Dirk has been on a tear too.
Dirk is good. He's good. I need about consistency.
But he's gotten better.
Much better.
He's gotten better.
Much better.
Yeah, for sure. I'm gonna attribute that to Lil Baby.
Dirk made me become a fan. I was not like from a jump. Like,
I'm gonna credit that to G Herbo and Lil Baby. I feel like they make him step his shit up.
For sure. It's good company.
Where we at?
To
oh God.
Good company to be in.
Here we go. From highs to lows.
Oof, this record, boy.
Let me ask you this before we get into this really bad record. What's your favorite Chainz album?
My favorite Chainz album are mixtapes, man. Like, the mixtapes
that's
are my
fair.
Favorite.
Yeah, that's fair.
Like,
that's
I'm a Cocaine Cowboys, you know, all that shit, you know what I mean?
Yeah, true.
Yeah, you know what I mean? Like, true.
I fuck with, I think, best album body of work is probably, my favorite, I won't say best. My favorite is Pretty Girls Like Trap Music. It had just enough for everything. It had really good singles.
That's what Good Drink, right?
The hits. Yeah, Good Drink's on there.
Yeah, that's
pretty
same.
Good. I mean, not pretty good. It had the hits.
Vibe is still my shit.
It had the clubs. Yeah. It had radio shit. And it had content shit.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, just overall.
That was the easy part. We're banging that Weezy hard.
Come on,
man.
Pockets.
Pockets,
all in
man.
That pocket.
Swinging on that shit,
all
bro.
All in that pocket. He got tons of joints. He tons got of tons joints. Of tons of really dope records.
He can do it. He can do it.
I'm saying, I don't got nothing else to prove. Just and give this us
is,
that shit.
And know? This is why, like, it's fucked up for me because I know it's like an ebb and flow. In my brain, right, it's always like, all right, you were here. Like, Dirk. Dirk has done this consistently.
Yeah.
Right? So I'm expecting everybody to do that. But it's like, my favorite Future record of all time is March Madness. That is a brilliant.
That's because it's his best record.
That is a brilliant record. So I thought, once I heard that, I was like, he's out of here. Like, he's going to be that next guy. He's about to step it up. And it was...
Nah.
Wiggy. It was not that.
I like that. I like Wicked, though.
I do like it, but my point is, it ain't nowhere near March Madness.
March Madness
Wicked had to still grow on me,
pinnacle.
Though. Yeah.
Yeah. That's the height of where he's been.
Like, how was that, like, your 2014 record?
Great record.
Phenomenal record.
Great record.
Hasn't topped it in 7 years.
All right, so let's go to the Caymans, shall we? You're going to have to take off your...
Do we?
You have to take off your Beyonce coat for the Caymans.
Do we?
Yo.
Speaking of, somebody say Formation?
right. Yo, Swae Lee ain't been the same since French...
What is going on?
Since French stole Unforgettable.
What is going on, man?
Swae Lee ain't been the same, bro. He's been chasing that record. It's one of the biggest records, period, in the last decade, right?
Yeah.
It's past Diamond.
Right.
It's huge. It's a global, international.
No, it got French living in Calabasas.
It's
man.
Just
yeah.
one of those ones. That was that boy record, though.
Lost the record, man.
Yeah, that boy lost that record.
He's still in the tarmac.
Hey. They forgot him. They forgot him. Unforgettable. Yo, he ain't been the same since he lost Unforgettable. Because this record right here
should have not been on this album.
This record is it's not the best Swae Lee we've heard.
This is not even the best. Yeah, it's one of the weakest records on the album, man. I was like, it's just pointless.
I don't even
have a lot of negativity to say about it. Like,
yeah, it should have just not made the album.
I mean, I agree.
Unfortunately, there's another. I have a homie that's been on. I don't even want to give too much away than people detectives.
Yeah,
I have a homie that has a way higher profile than they have a bank account.
We know a few.
And this and it's so unfortunate because. Like you said, people expect you to have money, and you're so famous.
Yeah.
You're almost so famous that you need to travel with security,
right.
But you can't afford to.
Can't afford it.
That's crazy.
It's insane.
That's crazy. Like, you think about that concept. You've been all over billboards and on the subways and all of this, right? So people instantaneously recognize your face, but you haven't made the money enough to afford the lifestyle that needs to come with that level of fame.
Exactly.
It's crazy. So when I hear that chorus, right, and it's so compelling, I wish that we could have delved into that more.
Right.
Because that's a real thing.
Great starting point.
Yeah, I gave that record a 7.5.
You see.
Word. All right,
let's get to it.
Let's get into this, man.
Let's get to it.
The title alone. Makes you pay attention. Vlad TV.
Absolutely.
Yeah, be.
So is this like marketing for Vlad TV, or like are they really like shitting on Vlad TV? I can't tell because like you give
it's both.
You give power to the name,
of course.
Like by titling, it's like Skydi Beam, right? Like you,
right.
Know, you give her more notoriety when you make her the title.
She had it already.
But it gives more, is what I'm saying.
Nope, not from me. It was the same level of notoriety.
It's other fans besides you, Torre.
I'm only fans, nigga.
I like it. It's only fans.
Shout out to Scotty V.
I'm only fans.
And congratulations to Scotty, man. She's doing amazing things. But yeah, man, it's both. It's both. Because you name, whether you like Vlad or not, whether you believe in what he does or not, whether you support him what he does or not, and if you want to denounce it, titling, you know, the best way to not give anything attention is not pay attention to it. This is not to blow it up.
Right,
once you
right,
give
right,
something
right,
attention,
right.
You bring eyes to it. You bring ears to it. If you title your song Vlad TV.
Or they're doing the responsible thing and putting street dudes on notice. Don't go on Vlad.
But
tell
it's making
yourself.
It bigger. It's still making the brand bigger.
Right, but it's also correcting. It's also self-correcting as well.
For
yeah,
sure.
Yes.
I said it's both.
Vlad will get some more interviews. Okay, fine, whatever. But like, I think
motherfucker's still gonna go sit on Vlad's couch, no matter what you say.
Right. I think the concern is that like, yeah, don't stop dudes from going on Vlad's couch, but stop dudes telling on themselves on Vlad's couch. Stop indicting yourself. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's really the problem.
If somebody got to tell you not to do that, then you might be in the wrong line of
work. I mean, most niggas in the street are dumb. I mean, like, come on now. It's not like...
Why? Do they don't walk into the precinct and say, I did it, though.
Oh, no, they do. They how you think Smurda got caught, bro?
Well, yeah, but this new
rapping with my guns on the Instagram, like, what are you talking about? Yo, they are walking into the precinct.
Oh, I forget the exact line, but Hov said, when I was Instagrams, the last thing you wanted was your picture taken.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? Exactly. That was a ball. Shout out to
Instagram.
Right.
Woo.
Picture taken. Instagram. But I digress. This is lyrically the best song on the album.
Hands down. Because it's actually all lyricists.
Yeah. For sure.
Yeah, man.
Shout out to Stove God Cook.
Funny thing is, all right, so Stove God is my guy. Love him. Mm-hmm. Right? He's just outlandish, right?
Very much so. You saw what I did to him on Sway, though, right?
You said what?
You saw what I did to him on Sway?
No, what? Oh, you mean y'all rap together?
Yeah.
Don't do that. Come on,
I'm chef. Can I chef?
I think I saw it. I was like, yo, boy, put your walk down right now, man. Put your walk down right now. That's actually funny. We need to bring that back, too. Woo! Anyway, don't do Aaron like that.
No,
man.
I like Aaron.
Don't do Aaron
like
that.
I like Aaron Cooks. I love Stone.
Don't do Aaron.
Cooks.
Don't do Aaron like that, man. Yeah, but he had to put on a costume now, to, you know, to beef it up. And it's been entertaining, you know what I'm saying? But I don't even think Stove God nor Chainz has the best verse on the song.
No, not at all.
I don't even know.
Stove God got the, and I'm not trying to, like, I don't even be rapping like that. So right, there's no disrespect to Santi.
He don't even be rapping, he be preaching and shit.
I love Reasonable Drought.
I love Reasonable Drought.
I'm definitely not trying to play Zion, but.
Sold a half a brick in what? The parking lot. Hallelujah.
What?
Whoever rapped last.
Went crazy.
Bruh.
Went crazy.
Oh, bruh.
You ever heard somebody go crazy?
Bruh.
Simba went crazy.
I watched my cuz drop out of USF to be like BMF.
Mm.
Set up a kitchen set in grandma's basement and started whipping wet.
Mm.
Granny asking, what's that smell? It's soap. I've been on CBS.
Mm.
Dog food, Granny. I got my pedigree from DMX.
Come on, man.
That's how he sets it off. Who are you, sir?
Yo, Finn, can we break that down?
Get that, bruh.
The soaps on CBS is crazy.
The soaps. On CBS. Why is the soap relevant to the kitchen though, Tor?
Come on, you already know what's going on. You already know what they're doing
in the kitchen,
you
man.
You know what they cooking up, man. And then the pedigree DMX is dog food. It's dog food, right? What's dog food? If you know, you know.
Yeah.
Well, so when you speak pedigree, mm-hmm. that ties you in to dog.
Mm-hmm.
You're already talking dog food, but he's talking about his pedigree, mm-hmm. but he got it from DMX.
Yo. Double and
that's a triple. He juggling.
Yikes.
He went crazy. I ran that verse back so many times.
Son, I was like, yo, who is this? Who is this?
I found his Instagram.
Oh, you did?
I'm
soon to get off. I'm like,
so what's your gram, bro?
Another fan, me.
Yeah, he went crazy.
What are your mixtape? Who you rap? Like, it's just like when I found, you know, 38 Special. I was like, okay, who's this? I need to go do the knowledge. I need all your mixtapes and you see what the fuck's going on.
Yeah. We want to know if this is a fluke or if you really. This can't be a fluke.
Bruh.
It can't be.
Not rapping like that.
Because
he didn't, like, he kept going. Nah, that whole verse.
Yeah,
stupid.
Nah, he went crazy. It's stacked. He went crazy. Yo, run that back, dog. This is literally how I listen to this song. Every time I listen to this song. I watch my cousin. His tone. Wait, pull break. Oh, stop the wrecking.
Talk to him, Tor. Get excited. That's what I'm talking about.
I mean, rapping like that, he might not do many interviews. You know what I mean?
Son.
He might be outside.
Outside, still.
For real. He went so foolish on this verse. What's our shit? Like, don't take a line off, right?
Son.
There are no lines taken off.
No vacation.
Shout out to our family, no bars off.
There's no vacation.
There's no lines taken off. Let's go. Let's get into this shit. Heron broke it down to O's.
The code word is HBO. What? Niggas what?
Broke it down to O's. Stop the record. Why is the record still playing?
The code word is HBO.
Heron broken down to O's. The code word
is HBO.
I heard you, fam.
Yeah.
Fam, I heard you.
New fan.
Yeah, nah, he went crazy.
New fan.
He went crazy. Two fans. You know what I mean?
Two fans.
Nah, he went crazy. That whole, like, second, after he gave you all this shit, and you know what I really love about how he went from the dog food to the DMX
mm-hmm.
to the Rough Riders, mm-hmm. to the lot. To like the he kept, yeah, he kept the thread going. Kept hitting you, kept and when he you. Finished that, he gave you the
some
new math. Math.
Give you some math.
He gave you the,
gave you some
he,
math.
Was
bro.
That Foxy Brown math?
No, it wasn't Foxy Brown.
Nah,
that was
man.
A, that was a That was good math.
That was good mathematics. Good mathematics. That was good mathematics. That was that Stephen Hawkins. You know what I mean? Yeah, nah, he went crazy. He went crazy. Best verse on the album. Amazing.
Best verse on the album is not by 2 Chainz.
Yeah, yeah. Kudos. Kudos to that.
You heard it here first.
I watched the nigga go on Glad TV.
I would love to get more of these on 2 Chainz project. Horde. You know, obviously just Horde. A hard beat and some fucking rapping mm-hmm. with the only intention to be some
the best verse on the song.
Yo, who won? Who gonna take the gold? Yeah. Who gonna take the silver? Who gonna take the bronze?
Who want the gold blender?
Yeah, like you know what I liked about Chainz's verse? The Nod to Luda. Because yeah, I feel like there's been so much friction. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Like, I thought that was classy.
It's a witty line, man.
Yeah.
Clever line.
The, like, and just, you know, just to show Luda love.
Bitch like Luda. Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, dope. Dope joint. Favorite joint on the project.
100%.
That's why I had to take back my original 8.5.
Gotcha.
And move that down to an 8. Because this is my, what would you give it?
I give it a 9.
Give it a 9?
Yeah.
You know what? This is going to happen in real time. I'm turning my 8.5 into a 9. It's a 9.
But we've talked so much about the best part of the song, which is lyricism. Like, but the beat,
the beat is crazy. The beat is crazy.
It's different from everything else on the album. Yo. It's almost like Welcome to Jam Rock. It has like a Roots vibe to it.
Yeah, for sure.
You know what I'm saying? Like, it could have had a fucking reggae hook. It would have still worked, man.
I mean, it got so much elements. Yeah, it feel like it. Like, if you in Jamaica and this come on, it don't feel foreign. It's a vibe. You know what I'm saying?
It's a vibe.
And make sure you watch where you at if you in Jamaica and you hear this song. It's dangerous. It might get dangerous.
Yeah, the booyakas are real.
It might get dangerous real quick.
The booyakas are real.
So that's a 9. That's a 9 for me, man. Yeah, favorite joint in the project. Ooh. Everybody went crazy on it. Yeah.
All right, and we're at the last stop.
Nope, I already got off the train.
You cannot go. You can't go.
What you mean? I left.
Can't
man.
Go.
I've stayed in Jamaica.
It's great adventures, bro. The ride ain't done. You can't get off till the ride's finished.
Who sequenced this album? Who said, you know what? After we come off of this masterpiece of a record,
let's go to Jacquees.
Yo, let's throw the Jacquees joint on last.
Jacquees is fire too, bro.
This is not even. I was in the studio with Jacquees a couple months ago. He plays some incredible records.
Jacquees is hard. He
plays some incredible records. He's talented.
And he sounds good on this.
He the king
I just don't
R&B.
Understand this record. Like,
he the king of R&B.
I just don't understand this record.
He the king.
At the end of, after,
king,
after,
he the king.
After Vlad TV.
R&B.
You know what I'm saying?
Reezy and Bonsu. R&B. Yo, the sequence it makes absolutely no sense. That's the way you end your album. Like, Dope Ain't Gonna Sell Itself is the title of the album. It's the thread all through that song.
Right.
That's how you end the album on
man.
A super high.
Super high, man.
You know what I'm saying? To end it with the Jacquees record, which is not only not the strongest, one of the stronger records on the project, but it's just ill placed.
Out of place.
It's ill placed. It should be way higher in the track listing. But it also happens to be, I think, one of my least favorite records on the project.
It is.
In general.
Because it sounds like 2 Chainz is over the album.
Bro, coming off that record, you set yourself up for failure, by the way. If You Want Me To, featuring Jacquees, I have questions. Mm. What is the purpose of this song? Is this the chick song? Is it the radio song? What is the purpose? What is the intention? What is the intent of this particular record?
It's a chick song.
Okay.
That he was hoping could get picked up with the spins. Like, you know, they would start playing in this and then give it some steam.
Why did you put this at the last on the album then?
I mean, I don't think it's that record. I don't care where it's placed. I don't think this record would be that anyway. But yeah, it just makes even less sense to be at the end, especially like you said, after Vlad TV.
Yeah.
Doesn't that make sense, man?
Yeah. Yeah,
like that's not even the vibe of the album to end it off like that.
Yeah, it's just a weird record. That's why I'm like, what's the purpose of the record?
Because what we haven't been talking about, like he got his man doing like these little skits throughout, mm-hmm. just to kind of keep us in like that trap element,
right?
And we end it with some old, you know, what you can do to a chick's body. It's like I don't get it.
I like the fractured wrist line. Slap the ass so hard.
It's funny.
He's witty. You know, I don't want to sit here, especially after we praised the Vlad TV record so much. I don't want to sit here and shit on this last record. Definitely one of my least favorites. I gave it a 7.5. I think that had it been higher in the track listing, I still would have gave it a 7.5. Right,
but I appreciate it.
But I would have, the album would have left me feeling good. I'm going to go do my Googles on the Major Major, though.
Same, brother.
I need to hear more joints.
We both be following him. He has two new fans. Yeah, he'll be, you know, he's going to know about Hard Earned as well.
For sure, for sure. Shout out to Scotty Meme. All right, we up out of here, man.
If you want respect, you got to earn it. You damn right.